You've been terrific. I got one last thing I'd like to show you. I hope you like it. I hope it works. It's kind of cool. That's it. Maybe this side of the audience will like it better. Thank you. You see, I never saw snow when I was a kid. I mean, I saw it on TV and in the movies, but I never saw snow for myself when I was a little kid. I grew up in New Jersey, but every winter my parents and I would drive to Florida to visit my aunt, so I never got a chance to really experience winter or snow for myself when I was growing up. When I was about 8 years old, I begged my mom and dad to stay in New Jersey for the winter, just so I could see snow for the first time. And they agreed. And that was the year there was no snow. Every day I'd pray for it to snow. No snow. I'd sit outside waiting for it to snow. It got closer and closer to Christmas. Still no snow. And on Christmas Eve, I was up in my windowsill in my room praying for it to snow, and I fell asleep at the window. And my father came and carried me to bed. And a few hours later, in the middle of the night, there was a knock on my bedroom door. It was my mother. She said, "David, wake up." And I woke up. She said, "David, look out the window." And I looked out the window, and it was snowing. And I couldn't believe it. Well, I ran outside, and I laughed, and I cried as the snow hit my face and my hands. That was the first magic I ever saw. And when spring came and the snow stopped, I'd cut up little pieces of paper and throw them in the air to try to recreate the feeling I felt when I saw snow for the first time. There was paper all over my house. But it was my way of keeping the magic alive all year long. Even today, I realize how important it is to keep that sense of wonder, that childlike hope, knowing if you believe and you want it enough, nothing's impossible.